from glory to glory, from glory to glory. This prophetic entrance service, I have the privilege given to me by God and his servant to invite some brethren in our midst to come forward to share testimonies of God's doing in their lives. As I call them out, kindly come forward to the altar. Gerald Agoya, put your hands together for them as they come. Brother Samuel Masharia Muraga. Sister Martha Masharia, Agatha Wanjiku, and Elder Philip Serem. They're coming. I have some testimonies to be read. A testimony from Brother Philip Musungu. Brother Philip testifies of a business breakthrough. Says, my business faced stagnation without any positive progress for over 3 years. I went for soul winning, and by God's grace, I won 6 souls who are now established here. To the glory of God, my business picked up well, registering massive profits. I returned to give God all the glory. Another testimony from Sister Esther Namayani. She testifies of instant healing during Shiloh. She says, I had suffered breast pain which had persisted for 1 year. Says, during the anointing ministration by Bishop David Oedepo, I took the oil after it was blessed and I felt sparks of fire coming from me. God instantly healed me. I gave him all the glory. Somebody shall receive their own healing in the name of Jesus. Another one from Sister Ruth Wambui. She testifies of instant healing. I was having chest pain, aching ribs, and coughing for about 1 week. I prayed to God, and during feet washing, I received instant healing miracle. I give God all the glory. Your names and what God did.
Praise God, church. My name is Samuel Macharia Muraga. I'm here to testify of God's greatness for excellent performance for my son, who sat for his exam last year, KCP, and when results were announced on Wednesday, he was position number 2 in the whole country. My second testimony is that my wife delivered a miracle baby on February 3rd, 2015, on a record time, 15 minutes without any pain. We give God all the glory.
Your hands together for Jesus.
Praise the Lord, church. My name is Ruth Wangui. This is my son, Gerald Agoya. I joined this commission on 15th of February. And by the time I joined this commission, my son was under very bad peer pressure. As a matter of fact, there was a time they had stolen something in a supermarket and he was about to be jailed. And by the time I came here, he was going through something. So when we came here in March, I told him, one day he told me he wanted to be prayed for. And I saw Pastor Sylvester passing and I told him, that's a pastor. So he was prayed for, and from that time he started performing well in school. And throughout, he went through Bible school. And after during the Bible school, I noted that he was closing himself in a room. And I kept asking, what are you doing there? And he told me, Mom, I'll tell you. Then after that, he showed me a book. This is the book. He has written a book. It's called Handling Peer Pressure in a Godly Manner. We want to give God glory because of that. In Jesus' name.
Your hands together for Jesus.
Praise God, church. From glory to glory. That's the new name that I have for 2016. My name is Martha Macharia. I was believing God for a miracle job with the U.S. Embassy, and God granted me exactly that. And not only that, it's a favor from the Lord. It's amazing. I tied my testimony to this altar. I told God I will never stand on this altar. I was in Turning Point. I helped build this sanctuary, and I told God, the day I stand there, let me give a powerful testimony. I'm working with the American Embassy outside the country, and to make the matters better, I am working with Department of State.
Glory to Glory Church. My name is Elder Philip Serem. I have two testimonies to share. On the 13th, immediately after the Shiloh Thanksgiving service, I was involved in church service. We had gone to buy something in the petrol station, and I was involved in a very serious accident. And by the grace of God, by divine intervention, I came out of that accident with no injuries. On that particular day, as I was in the hospital, the arrow, the Pastor Victor, they came to the hospital to pray for us. And as I was still waiting for checkup, I managed to inform Pastor Victor that my dad also was coming on his way from home. He had an injury, and he was coming for an operation in Nairobi. So he prayed for me in that particular place. I want to declare that my dad was able to undergo through that operation in the speed time available, and is now all recovering. The Lord provided resources for that operation, and I want to give God all the glory for all that he did for us in that month.
From Glory to Glory Church. My name is Wanda. This girl by my side is called Agatha Wajiko. She's here this morning to glorify God for what God has done in her life, for excellence performance. She attempted the KCSE, that is last year, and she managed to scoop 400 marks to the glory of God. We thank God. I remember I'm here as a mentor, and the mama is also in the house this morning. And she, every single Sunday, the mother would come with a Thanksgiving offering. And every single time she kept on telling God, I'll go to Baba Tabli. She would say, Lord, I thank you for continuing good grains. That is, in Andivan, she was giving thanks to God for what the girl was to get. And right now, she is here to return all the glory back to God in Jesus' name. Thank you.
From glory to glory, God has done everything well. We have every reason to lift our voices to appreciate him, to return all the glory to him for excellent performance in KCPA, for divine healing, for miracle job. Truly, God has done it. Father, in the name of Jesus, mighty God, we appreciate you. We thank your Lord for the great and mighty things that you've done in the lives of your children. We bless your holy name. We return all the glory and honor to you, knowing that even this hour, you are set to do great things in our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' precious name, we have given thanks. Kindly put your hands together for Jesus.
All you have to do, 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 hey, let it arise, 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 let your glory arise, let your glory arise, let your glory come.
I need it, let it come down,
let your glory arise, let your glory arise, let your glory come down.
I need it, let it come down,
let your glory come down.
I need it, let it come down. come down.
Let your glory come down.
I need it, let it come down.
Let your glory come down.
I need it, let it come down.
Let your glory come down.
It doesn't matter what you're going through. It doesn't matter what you're looking for. It doesn't matter how dark your night may be. I just wanna let you know that
it is alright. It is okay. It is alright. It is okay.
Oh, there's somebody, it is alright.
It is alright.
Oh, yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Oh, there's somebody, yeah, it is alright.
Right.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Oh, there's somebody, yeah, it is alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Oh, there's somebody, it is alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Oh, there's somebody, it is alright.
It is alright.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Do you know why?
Do you know why?
I ask you, do you know why? I'm sure you like to know why.
You like to know why.
The Bible says, he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High God shall abide
under the shadow
of the Almighty. And we will say, the Lord is my strength,
the Lord is my strength,
the Lord is my shield,
the Lord is my shield,
on him alone will I stand. This is the reason I say, come on, tell somebody, it is alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody, it is alright.
Right.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody, it is alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell your brother,
yeah,
it is
yeah.
alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody, yeah, it is alright.
It is alright.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Do you know why?
Do you know why?
I ask you, do you know why? I'm sure you like to know why. The Bible says, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. And every tongue that rises up against you in judgment, I say you will condemn. Come on, tell somebody, it is alright.
Right.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody, it is alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody, it is alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody, it
yeah,
is
yeah.
alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody, yeah, it is alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody, it is alright.
It is alright.
Hey, yeah, 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 yeah.
Don't you cry. Don't you worry no more. Don't you cry. Don't you worry no more.
Don't you cry.
Don't you cry.
Don't you worry.
Don't you worry no more.
Don't you cry.
Don't you cry.
Don't you worry.
Don't you worry no more.
You are moving higher.
Don't you cry.
Don't you cry.
Don't you worry no more.
You are moving from glory to glory.
Don't you cry.
You are flying high.
Don't you worry no more.
Don't you cry. Say.
Don't you cry.
Don't you worry no more.
Don't you worry no more.
Say. Don't you cry. Don't you.
Don't you cry.
You are going higher.
Don't you worry no more.
Come on, tell somebody, it is alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody, it is alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
Okay.
Come on, tell somebody, it is alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody, it yeah, is yeah. alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you, it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody, yeah, it is okay.
It is alright.
Come on, tell somebody it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody it is alright.
Right.
Oh yes, I tell you it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody it is alright.
It is alright.
Oh yes, I tell you it is okay.
It is okay.
Come on, tell somebody it is alright.
It is alright.
Service in the year 2016. Give the Lord a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. I would like you to show how grateful you are to God for seeing the first Sunday of the year by giving your neighbor beside you a high five. Two, three neighbors beside, high five, high five. You made it. You made it. You made it. You made it into this year. You made it into this year. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Give him a praise. Give him a shout. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Glory to God. And in this new year of 2016, everything shall be all right for you in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever has not been okay in 2015, it shall be supernaturally made right in your life this year in the name of Jesus Christ. In this new year, you shall be a surprise to yourself and to your family and to your neighborhood and to your community and to your nation in the name of Jesus. This year, God has ordained it for multiple change of levels for you in the name of Jesus Christ. It's a year of no shame. It's a year of no tears. A year of no sorrow. That shall be your story this year in the name of Jesus Christ. From glory to glory. And from glory to glory. That is where I'm going. Come on, show that you're going somewhere. One more time. From glory to glory. That is my new name. And from glory to glory. That is where I'm going. And you will arrive there in the name of Jesus. Give the Lord a shout of praise. Hallelujah! Praise God! You are most welcome in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We thank God for seeing us into another year. We thank God for granting us journey mercies to and fro during the Christmas season. Quite a number of you traveled for Christmas. The whole city was looking deserted. But blessed be God, you are back. And you are back alive and well and strong. To God be all the praise and all the glory. Praise the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Happy New Year to everyone in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You are blessed in Jesus' name. Put your hands together for Jesus. You may please be comfortably seated in the presence of the Most High God. Hallelujah. Praise God. As a praise God. This service this morning is quite unique. It is our first service in our new year, our first Sunday service in this new year. And it also doubles for us this morning as our prophetic impartation service. A special impartation service through the ministry, or mystery rather, through the mystery of the mantle. And I know that today, as someone comes in contact with the mantle from God's servant,
the grace you need to change levels in all areas of your endeavor shall be imparted unto you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We have come to the beginning, the foundation for the rest of the year. And the way you lay your bed, like they normally say, is the way you lie on it. And therefore, in this first few days of the week, of the year, first few days of the month, first few days of the year is still young. The year is still young. The year is still pregnant. In this first few days of the year, you begin to lay a very solid foundation for the remaining part of the year 2016. Architects and civil engineers and building engineers tell us that the depth of the foundation determines the height of the building. So if you want to fly high and soar high in 2016, then you must lay a very solid foundation for yourself now. Praise God. So everything designed for us within these first few weeks of this year is so that we can lay such a foundation that will guarantee exploits for us in 2016. It is wisdom to invest in your future. It is wisdom to invest in your tomorrow. Praise God. For that reason, every activity for this week is highly important. Especially our covenant, our prayer. Be part of it. And then, of course, the special workers meeting that is taking place this Saturday from 9 a.m. in the morning. Very important for all of our workers. When we say workers, we mean all of our ordained pastors. Pastors who are ordained as pastors here and we recognize as our pastors here. All of our ordained pastors, all of our ordained elders, all of our ordained deaconesses. When I mean ordained, that means you have been ordained here. Oil has been poured on your head here. Praise God. So all our ordained elders, ordained deacons, and ordained deaconesses, and all of our statutory body members, FMC, LCC, church board, all, not some, all of our home cell fellowship ministers, all the ministers at our home cell level, the district pastors of our home cell, zonal pastors, home cell leaders, assistant home cell leader, secretaries of the home cell, you are all to be part of that meeting this coming Saturday. All of our unit leaders and the members, all unit leaders and all of our unit members, all. I singled out unit leaders so that the unit leaders can, you know, that you have the responsibility to ensure that your members of your unit or the members of your units are part of that meeting, special meeting, because we shall be setting the pace for the remaining part of the year. It's coming up this Saturday, 9 a.m., and along the line, we shall be hooking up to our international base to receive prophetic instructions and prophetic blessings from the mouth of God's servant, the president over this commission. So it's a highly important meeting that no one here should afford to miss it. No one here can afford to miss that meeting for any reason. If you are traveling, cancel the trip. Am I communicating right now? So you have 1 week to prepare and cancel the trip. Praise God. Come on, sir, praise God. And for that reason, we are not having the early morning prayer of 6 to 7. We are not having it so that everybody can be part of it. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Even the water baptism, we shifted it from 9 o'clock now to 12:15 so that after we finish, before they can attend to them, if they are still available. Praise the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah! So every one person who is called a worker in this church, CCU, choir, ushering, sanctuary keepers, name them, children's Sunday school teachers, our fellows, the studio, all, medical, Gilead Medical, every person must be in attendance. Every one worker in the church must be where? Must be in attendance of that meeting. The Lord grant you understanding as you come in Jesus' mighty name. We will take the attendance, and if you are not there, you are already telling us that you are not part of the workforce for this year. Praise the mighty name of Jesus Christ. If you are not there, you are only telling us by your absence that you are trying to deregister yourself from the workforce of the commission here in Kenya this year. But that should not be the case with you in the name of Jesus Christ. Grace to be a part of that meeting. Receive that grace right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Come on, say amen. And then coming Sunday is our communion for supernatural strength. Glory to God. Why? Because from Monday the 11th to the 31st, as was announced to us during the Kesha by our Father in the Faith, that we shall be embarking on our annual 21 days prayer and fasting. Glory to God. So everyone must prepare himself to be part of that session of prayer and fasting. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Am I communicating right now? Within the course of the week, we shall give you details. And of course, next Sunday, we'll clarify much more on the prayer and fasting by next Sunday. But please get yourself set, because this is the foundational month of the year. And we're laying foundation for the remaining 11 months. And hey, friends, no one here shall end up with less than the manifestation of God's glory in his or her life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. If you're that person, let your amen be the loudest. Glory to God. You are blessed in Jesus' mighty name. Stickers are still available. Ensure you buy stickers for your cars and for your houses. Please ensure you get to the bookshop and buy those stickers, and then you shall be blessed as you do so in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It shall be a mark of no touch. Amen. A touch not mark. A touch not mark on you and your household and your vehicle in the name of Jesus Christ. So you are blessed as you take part of it or as you purchase it and place on your cars or your houses in Jesus' mighty name. Now, as we enter into the word for this morning, Father, speak unto us right now in Jesus' mighty name. Let your word descend upon us as dew from heaven in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And let everyone here go home refreshed and renewed and strengthened by the Holy Ghost in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord, for doing it. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen and amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, this month has been declared unto us by his servant, as it was read to us in the prophetic focus, as prayer and fasting facilitates fulfillment of prophecy. Prayer and fasting facilitates the fulfillment of prophecy. So in this year of 2016 that's been tagged from glory to glory, we are laying the foundation this month as we look at prayer and fasting facilitates fulfillment of prophecy. And the teaching series for all of our Sunday services is understanding the blessedness of prayer and fasting. Understanding the blessedness of prayer and fasting. Praise God. So this is part number one. And we shall go through part number 2, 3, 4, and 5 for the 5 Sundays of this year. And as time goes on, we shall be letting you understand and to know exactly what each Sunday will be holding for us. Praise God. We are starting with an impartation service today. And then next Sunday is a communion service. Communion for supernatural strength. Communion for supernatural strength. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Communion for the release of God's grace and strength in your life. For the release of his direction and his wisdom in your life. So you can't afford to miss any of the Sundays of this month. They are foundational, they are critical, they are important. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Please understand this from the very onset of this message this morning, that everything about God is in his glory. Everything about God. Everything about God, who he is, what he does, is in his glory. That is his presence. His wisdom is in his glory. His power is in His glory. His nature is in His glory. His character is in His glory. His will is in His glory. His provision, everything about God, everything is in His glory. So when you see God's glory be made manifest, you are seeing God manifesting who He is. And it's important for you to understand that His purpose on earth, God's purpose on earth is to manifest His glory for all to see and to draw men into His glory. Take note of what I'm saying right now. It will help you. This is the purpose of God here on earth. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. How does He want to manifest His glory on earth for everyone to see? By making us, we the believers, partakers of His glory. And for us to reflect His glory. How do I know that? Check through scriptures. In Numbers 14 verse 21, God speaking there said, "But as truly as I live, all the earth shall be filled with the glory of the Lord." Come on, all the earth shall be. He said, as God swear. He swore by Himself that as truly as I live, all the earth shall be filled with the glory of the Lord. What does He mean by that? Look at it, the next verse. In Numbers 14 and 22, He said, "Because all those men which have seen My glory and My miracles, which I did in Egypt and in the wilderness, and have tempted Me now these 10 times, and have not hearkened to My voice." Now, He was saying that the earth shall be filled with glory. Why? Because there were men, there were people in Israel, or the men of Israel doubted Him. The men of Israel limited the Holy One of Israel by their unbelief. They limited Him by their attitudes. They did not allow Him to manifest Himself the way He ought to, or He wanted to. And He said, "Look, I swear that no matter what happens, everyone will see Me the way I really am. I will show My miracles. I will show My wonders. I will show My signs. I will show Myself. I will manifest Myself the way I really am. People will see Me." And how will He do it? Through Me and through you. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. That is why what we're going through this year is critical. Very important. Because that is the desire of the Almighty God, to be seen in us and for His glory to be manifested through us. Look at it in John 17, for example. Jesus, while praying, and I will advise you to go read John 17 because it's critical to our understanding. It is critical to understanding what God is set to do in our midst this year. John 17, very important scripture. But in that scripture, Jesus, while praying for the church, praying for His disciples and praying for the church, praying for me and you by extension, Jesus said in verse 22 of John chapter number 17, He said, "And the glory which Thou gavest Me, I have given them." Do you see that? "The glory which You gave Me, I have given them, that they may be one, even as We are one." Verse 23, "I in them and Thou in Me, that they may be made perfect in one, and that the world may know that Thou hast sent Me and hast loved them as Thou hast loved Me." Verse 24, "Father, I will that they also, whom Thou hast given Me, be with Me where I am, that they may behold My glory, which Thou hast given Me, for Thou lovest Me before the foundation of the world." Can you see that? Can you see that God's will is for you to partake of His glory and for you to reveal or manifest His glory? Praise God. It's not just for you to see His glory. He wants you equally to be a partaker of it and a manifestor, or if you like, a reflector of that same glory. And that is where the theme, the anchor scripture for this year becomes very relevant. 2 Corinthians 3 and verse 18. 2 Corinthians 3, 18, and the scripture says, God speaking there said, "But we are with open face." So it is open to all. It's open to all. It's open to all. "But we are with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image." Can you see that? That is the ultimate of God for your life and my life. "But we all, with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, are changed. This year, a change is coming your way in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I said, this year, a change is coming your way in the name of Jesus Christ. are changed into the same image. The same image of the glory. From glory to glory. Even as by the Spirit of the Lord. So whatever you have seen hitherto, whatever you have seen before now, that looks like a blessing, is nothing compared to what God will do in your life this year. Because it's important for you to know that glory is in degrees. The glory of God is in degrees. Why? Because God himself is infinite. God is infinite. There's no limit to God. So there can be no limit to his glory. There are depths and dimensions of glory that you and I are yet to uncover. So never think you have arrived. Let no one here think he has arrived anywhere. We have not seen anything yet. Come on. We have not seen anything yet. For example, we were celebrating 50,000 seater auditorium, the largest auditorium in the world. Hey, largest in the world. That should be enough for us to relax. But at Shiloh, from glory to glory, Shiloh, God opened another chapter for us again, a higher dimension of glory, which nobody has ever had before in his life. That 100,000 seater now, twice what we had before. 100,000 seater auditorium is what we are aiming at now. Fully air conditioned. And according to God's servant, even the toilets have AC. So where you are now is the least place you will ever be in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. By the time this year is ending, you will be in your multiplied state in the name of Jesus. And God, speaking through his servant, said that every 3 months of this year, every quarter of this year, you and I shall be having a quantum leap forward in the mighty name of Jesus. There shall be an eruption in your life that will bring about a dramatic change of level every 3 months of this year in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Come on, if you believe it, let your amen be the loudest. Somebody be promoted 4 times this year. The doubting Thomas says, hey, Pastor Casey, you have come again. Promotion is only done once in a year. But in this year of from glory to glory, what eyes have not seen, what ears have not heard, what has never entered the heart of man before, what has never been recorded before, it shall be recorded concerning your case in the name of Jesus. Before this year is over, somebody here will be 4 times his present size in the name of Jesus. Someone seated here today, you have never gone on an international trip before. But before this year is over, you will have gone international 4 times in a row in the name of Jesus Christ. Do you know what we're talking about now? It means now, listen, it's for us, for my heart and your heart to be stirred up and catch the vision that God has for us this year. It means, in other words, that if I only won 1 soul last year, this year, at least 12, not one, not 4, 12 must follow me to church this year. That's what it means. From glory to glory. If I had only 1 car last year, this year, how many cars are coming my way? Oh, no, you didn't. Maybe these pastors and elders believe. How many cars are coming your way this year? Minimum 4 are coming your way this year. Somebody saying, Pastor, I don't even have the spoke of a bicycle. Talk less of car, Pastor Casey. That is how the minister of agriculture said in 2 Kings chapter number 7. The prophet came by the Holy Ghost and said, by this time tomorrow, the famine will be ended and food will be abundant on the street. It will be sold for less than nothing. Food will be sold for less than nothing. And the minister of agriculture said, man of God, prophet, please be prophesying within the limits of economic principles. Let your prophecy line up with science. How can you be saying something that is impossible? Even if God will open the windows of heaven, can this thing be? And the prophet looked at me and said, your eyes will see it. You will see it with your eyes, but you won't taste it with your mouth. And that's exactly what happened. That the next day, by the intervention of heaven, food was more than abundant in the same place where there was famine. So right now, there may be famine in your life. Maybe right now, shame is around your life. Maybe right now, your name and shame are synonymous. But by the end of this year, God will have changed your story in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise God. But we all, with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord. So our job is behold the glory. Our assignment this is to what? Is to behold the glory. To fix our eyes on Jesus. Woo-hoo. To fix our eyes on who? On Jesus. To fix our eyes on Jesus. Fix our eyes on the word. Fix our eyes on what God has said to us. And forget about the outcome. He will take care of the outcome. He said, you just focus your attention on where I'm pointing. Focus your attention on me. Look to me and leave. Look to me, the Holy Ghost is saying. Look up to me and forget about the outcome. I will take care of the outcome. Look to me. Do everything I tell you to do and forget about the outcome. I will take care of the outcome. This year, as you and I behold his glory, I decree that the most outstanding testimony shall be recorded in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Can I shock some people here? Just as after the KPC or KCP, ZKCP they call it. After the KCP, those of them that took number one and number two and number three, they were coming to them. Journalists were coming to small children. Am I communicating? That's what I was told. I didn't see it, but I was told. Is it true? After KCP, the ones that excelled, they were looking for them. Journalists were looking for them. That is how, before the end of this year, journalists will come looking for you in the name of Jesus Christ. They will interview you on the radio and TV in the name of Jesus Christ. By the closing of last year, one of us sent me a text, a mind-blowing text. In fact, the reason why I've not even shared it because I want to take them to verify what the man is saying first. I'm openly confessing to you, sir. I found it difficult to grasp. Not that I found it difficult to believe, but to grasp. To grasp it was something else. He had testified here before, about 2 years ago, about starting a city, a mining city. And the close of last year, investors came, according to his testimony, which, like I said, I was trying to verify. Even up to now, I have not, but I believe him all the same. It was just too mind-boggling to swallow. Not that I don't believe, I believe anything. But you mean that people are ready to sink $7 billion to developing that city, and he was there to sign. In fact, the time I called him, when I saw the text, I now called the number. Hello, yes, sir. Please, a minute. He came out and said, I'm just out from the meeting where they're signing memorandum of agreement with the investors. For how much? $7 billion. How much is that in shillings? Okay, you see, you are not clapping because you too, you find it difficult to believe. Woo! Calculate that in shillings. Your mind will just begin to spin. Can that be possible? Now, but what eyes have never heard, never seen, what ears have never heard, God will do it in your own life this year in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now, how do we partake of his glory? Very quickly. How do I partake of his glory? If this thing must happen in my life this year, how do I connect with it? Number one, you must be born again. Number one is through salvation. You must be born again. Amen. How do you know that? 2 Peter 1 verse 3. 2 Peter 1 verse 3 tells us, according as his divine power has given unto us all things that pertains unto life and godliness through the knowledge of him that has called us to glory and virtue. So your call to salvation is a call to glory. Your call to salvation is a call to glory. Praise God. So you must be born again. Why? Because Romans 3 verse 23 tells us, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. So since the fall of Adam in the Garden of Eden, man was cut off from partaking of the glory of the Most High God. So in order for you to partake of this glory, you must be born again. You must be born again. That's where the prayer of Jesus in John 17 becomes relevant. He said, the glory you have given me, I have given them. Who are they them? Those who are redeemed. Those who are washed and sanctified by the blood of Jesus. So salvation is the key to your glorification. Praise God. Come on, sir. Praise God. For whom he did foreknow, them he also called. Them he called, he justified. Them he justified, he also glorified them. Praise God. So how do I partake of this glory? How does it become a reality in my life this year? So that it doesn't just end up being a song, but practical manifestation of God's glory in my life. How? Number two is through prayer and fasting. Through what? Prayer and fasting, amongst others. Now, as the month rolls on, we shall be opening up to you chapter upon chapter, line upon line, precept upon precept, the things that you and I must do in order for his glory to find expression in our lives. But for this service, these two must suffice you right now. These two, very important. Be born again. And number two, engage yourself in the spiritual exercise of prayer and fasting. And this is a commandment of the Lord. It is what God has commanded me and you to do if we must see his glory manifest in our lives. So prayer and fasting are commanded by God for our profiting. It is for our own profiting. Every commandment of God is to your advantage. You find that in 2 Timothy 3, verse 16 to 17, that all scripture, all instructions of scriptures are by the inspiration of God and is profitable unto us for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect and thoroughly furnished unto all good works. So every instruction of scripture is for your own benefit. Listen to me. God doesn't need you in order for him to show forth his glory. Am I communicating right now? If you refuse to do what he has said, others will do it without you. Am I communicating right now? So God doesn't need you. You are the one that need him. He's not depending on you. You are the one depending on him. So every instruction of God is not for his benefit, but for your own benefit. You are the one that needs his glory. He already dwells in glory. Am I communicating right now? He already dwells in glory. He is glorious in holiness, fearful in praises. He is glorious. It is you that need his glory manifest in your life. Because it is his glory at work in your life that will terminate every shame and reproach in your life. The struggling of man started when there was Ichabod. When the glory of God departed, then the struggling of mankind started. When they were in the Garden of Eden, God came down to commune with them. He was communing with them. Praise God. Come on, sir. Praise God. Why? Because they were enveloped with his glory. His glory clothed them. We don't have time to go into the theology of that. But the glory of God was the clothing of Adam and Eve. But when they sinned, the glory left them. And they could not see their physical nakedness. They have been naked. They had always been naked physically. They had always been naked. But they were enveloped by something else. Something else covered them. And when that thing left, then their physical nakedness became apparent. But it wasn't physical nakedness that they saw, but the nakedness of their soul. Why? The glory left. His presence left. His power left. His character left. His nature left. Everything about him left them. And they could no longer commune with him. When he came in the Garden of Eden, they ran to hide. They couldn't access his glory anymore. And that led to their exit out from the garden of beauty and blessing. That's why he has commanded, if you want to see my glory restored back to your life, apart from being born again, engage in prayer and fasting. Because every commandment of God is for your benefit, not for your hurt. Praise the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Come on, say, praise the name of Jesus Christ. Please, you must note that you have to take personal responsibility for the change of level that you are looking for. God's servant told us that in our Kesha, crossover Kesha. You must take personal responsibility. If you must experience a change of level, you must. There are certain things that we take for granted here on earth, which nobody can do for you but for yourself. Because it is for your own benefit and to your benefit. No one can breathe for you. The breathing of air through your nostrils to your lungs. No one can breathe for you. If you need fresh air, you must breathe in fresh air and breathe out carbon dioxide by yourself. Fresh air must be taken in through to your lungs and you breathe out carbon dioxide by yourself. Nobody can do it for you. In fact, when you are unable to do it, they fix machines. Machines now try to help you to breathe. Because you must breathe if you must survive. Nobody eats for you. You eat for yourself. Am I communicating right now? Everyone that wants to pass exam, I mean every credible person, not those who like kumbia lifestyle. I mean, the reason why men are crooked is because they refuse to follow the pathway of life. Am I communicating right now? You want to pass exam, you must study. Those who refuse to are the ones that go and bribe lecturers and bribe to steal papers and then come and cheat to pass. By the time you employ them, you notice they cannot perform. They can't perform because they cheated to get the paper. But in this one, sir, nobody can cheat. Nobody can bribe. Am I communicating right now? I said, am I communicating right now? If you engage in what God is saying to do, to pray and fast, the glory will make manifest. It will show in your life. It will show in your life. It will show in your life. It will show. The testimonies will spring forth. Praise God. Signs and wonders will follow you. Doors will open unto you. Listen to me. As you engage in this systematic and strategic prayer and fasting, I see strange happenings occur in your own life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Many of you will write a book just like that small boy. Small boy had a challenge before he came. When he came to this church just around February, his mother came and he came. He was struggling. But he attended Bible school and whatever it is and was coming to church. And after a while, the boy sat down now to write a book. The boy that was having challenge academically, the boy that was having challenge morally, now sat down to write a book how to overcome challenges of peer pressure, which he was going under. He had that challenge. Now he's writing how to, come on, come on, come on. By the time 21 days prayer and fasting are over, somebody here will write a book of his own experience in the name of Jesus Christ. So brace up and prepare yourself for a glorious flight in 2016. Wait upon the Lord in prayer and fasting. And there are several benefits of prayer and fasting as listed in Isaiah 58. We don't have time to go through it, but we shall be going through every segment of it within the course of this 1 month. So within the course of 1 month, the things listed in Isaiah 58, we shall be going through step by step, precept upon precept, bringing out from those scriptures the blessings and the power that is in prayer and fasting. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Let no devil deceive you. Let nobody deceive you and you become like Esau, who had no regard for his destiny. Am I communicating right now? Don't be like Esau. Esau was one man who had no regard for his future and sold his birthright for a morsel of bread. His stomach ruled his life. His stomach and his appetite ruled his life and ruined his destiny. You know the story quite well. The story of this man called Esau. In Genesis 25, from verse 21 to verse 34, you find all of the story there. But you know it, how he came back and told Jacob, his brother, give me some porridge. I'm dying of hunger. Give me porridge. I want to eat. And he said to him, okay, if you want my food, give me your birthright. And Esau said, what is birthright? Nonsense. Take the birthright, my friend. Give me food. I want to eat now. I'm dying. And that was the end of it. For just some few minutes of satisfaction, physical satisfaction, he sold his birthright. He had no regard for the future. He only regarded the present. Am I communicating right now? He traded off his future for the present. Esau traded off his inheritance for food. Esau traded off his destiny for physical pleasure, temporal pleasure and enjoyment. Don't be like Esau, who later on regretted every step he took and came for a receipt and there was no chance for it. You find that in the book of Hebrews 12, verse 16 to 17. He came for a receipt. You know, when you fail exam, you come for a receipt. He came for a receipt, and there was no chance for a receipt for Esau. Don't be like Esau. Don't suffer the predicament of Esau. That when people are waiting upon the Lord in prayer and fasting, you are out there serving King's stomach. Yes, it's so in scripture. In Philippians chapter number 3, you find some people have made their God their belly. Philippians 3:19 says that some people have made their belly their God. Their belly is the one ruling their lives. But for you, your life and destiny shall not be ruined by King's stomach in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So today, you must dethrone King's stomach so that God can be enthroned in your life, so that his glory can be seen in your life in this new year in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Am I communicating here today at all? I say, am I communicating here today at all? Hey, please understand this. The glory of God is the greatest asset you can ever have here on earth. Your greatest quest should be for the reflection and the manifestation of his glory in your life. That will terminate every sweat of your brow. The glory of God. So don't trade it off for just some small Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola. Mandazi. For how many hours? Maximum 12 hours. Maximum. Max 12. Of course. Because by the time you finish eating your food at night, maybe you ate your dinner at 8 p.m., you go to bed for about 5 to 6 hours. You wake up and then you brush your teeth and you will actually start your day maybe around 5 or 6. So basically, it's just about 12 hours that you have to endure, but not enduring anything. 12 hours of craving and searching and pressing after God and his glory. Come on. Everyone that wants to see the glory of God must go for it, sir. Moses said, show me your glory. Am I communicating right now? If you want to see his glory, you must press for it. If you want to see his glory, you must press for it. Press for it. Press for it. Go home and study the book of Exodus 33. You'll find how Moses was pressing for God. I'll come to that later on in the course of the teaching. He pressed in for God. Praise God. So this 21 days prayer and fasting is ordained for me and you to press into his glory so that that glory can find expression in your life and my life. In every dimension of our lives. I told you already that the glory, everything God is in his glory. Everything about God is in his glory. His nature is in his glory. His character is in his glory. His power is in his glory. His wisdom you find in his glory. So everything about God is wrapped up in glory. When that glory begins to show forth in your life, his wisdom will show forth. His power will show forth. His anointing will show forth in your life. Grace will follow you wherever you go. Am I communicating right now? And when people see God's glory at work in your life, they will say, oh, this must be God. Glory to God. This can only be God. Glory to God. That is how people shall be exclaiming concerning you in this year 2016 in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. They will see the outcome. The reason say, wow, this is God. Glory to God. We have never seen it before like this. Wow, wow, wow. At the end of the day, God will change your story dramatically for everyone to see in the name of Jesus Christ. You know what? Like God's servant said, before this year runs out, they will roll out red carpet, red carpet, red carpet. They will roll out red carpet for someone here in the name of Jesus Christ. How? Through the manifestation of his glory. Through the manifestation of his glory. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. I said, praise the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Come on, say hallelujah. So please understand this. King's stomach must be dethroned today. As you partake of this mantle, of this mystery right now through the mantle. The grace to let go of, to subdue. Grace to subdue your physical appetite. So that you can connect with the Spirit of God. That grace shall be released upon you today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Praise God. Come on, sir. Praise God. I want your understanding to open up to what we are up to receive. You are receiving a touch from heaven that you will never recover from. Am I communicating here right now? I say, am I communicating right now? look, what we are saying is this, that by the time God and God's glory is manifested in your life, by the time his presence is seen at work in your life, contracts will chase you. You are not to chase them, they will chase you. Somebody didn't hear that. I said the things you are chasing, the contracts you are busy sweating to get, they will now be calling you, hello, is that the King James? Yeah, somebody gave us your CV. We have checked through your CV and we're very impressed with your CV and with your accomplishments. Please, can we have a chat with you? No, please, I'm very busy. Please, we are looking for, okay, we have open. Anytime you are free, come and see us. And when you come, they say, well, we have checked through and you are the man to do the job. Well, look, we have some 10 billion shillings job here. We want you to execute for us. And you don't have to chase for the money. Payment will give you some upfront. Mobilize you 50% upfront. So you don't have to look for money to, we'll give you the money to execute the job. A strange order of things will begin to happen to you or follow you when his presence or his glory is at work in your life. That is what I see God doing in someone's life here this year in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Jobs will be looking for you. Promotion will come knocking on your door. That's why when God's servant said that every 3 months, right, there'll be a quantum leap. It is not by power or by might, but by the manifestation of the glory of God. Praise God. Come on, say praise God. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. There are certain things plaguing you today, stopping you right now, that can only respond to prayer and fasting. That's why you must pray. Certain things sitting on your destiny, sitting on your life, sitting on your job, sitting on your career, sitting on your marriage, can only respond to the force of prayer and fasting so that his glory can be seen in your life. They came to cast out demons and they couldn't in the time of Jesus. In Matthew chapter number 17, verse number 20. And when Jesus came, they said to him, how come we could not cast this devil out? Why couldn't we cast the devil out? Jesus said, it's because of your unbelief. But verily I say unto you, if you have faith, he said, you say to this man, he said, but, verse 21, but this kind goeth not out but by prayer and fasting. This kind, you have to apply some other force to get this one out of your way. That's why I know as someone here engages himself in prayer and fasting this month, every devil sitting on your destiny, I see them uprooted in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Fasting spiritually expedites answers to prayers. That is, everything that prayer does is what fasting facilitates. Fasting and prayer go hand in gloves. Fasting expedites answers to prayer. Fasting spiritually expedites answers to prayers. And the same thing, prayer also gives value to fasting. This kind going not out but by prayer and fasting. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. When you fast, your prayers are speedily answered. Isaiah 58 verse 9. Isaiah 58 verse 9, he said, then you shall call and the Lord shall answer you. You will cry and say, here am I. Praise God, as you engage in a fast. Glory to God. And then, of course, when you pray, it gives value to the fasting. Fasting is a spiritual device whereby the natural physical man is subdued so that the spirit man can be enhanced in order to connect and commune with God. Fasting is a spiritual medium or spiritual device whereby the carnal man, the natural man, is subdued so that the spiritual man is enhanced in order to connect or commune with God. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So fasting doesn't change God. Your fasting actually changes you. When you engage in a fast, God is not changed. He is the eternal I am. God remains as the eternal I am that I am. He will never change because of your fast. The fasting that you embark upon will change you. Go home and read Isaiah 58 and beginning from verse 6 down the line, you will see everything about the virtues of fasting as enumerated in scriptures. And we're going to look at some of them very briefly before we leave this place today. What has this fasting and prayer got to offer for me? When you know what it has got to offer, then you are motivated to search or seek after it. Am I communicating right now? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. As I praise the name of Jesus Christ. But please, in order for you to enjoy profit in this fasting, let's look at some profitable approach to fasting and prayer. Some profitable approach to fasting and prayer. Number one, if your fasting must deliver to you the glory of God, number one, you must define your goals and objectives. Define what your goals and objectives are in fasting. You know, you can fast for the sake of fasting. Some people fast for the sake of fasting. Some people fast for dieting. They want to diet. They want to reduce their weight. Am I communicating right now? I say, am I communicating right now? Some fast just to reduce weight. Say, I am too robust, so I want to be skinny mini. I'm watching my weight. So for that reason, well, this fasting is good for me, you know, and I'm going to reduce weight. If that is the essence of the fasting, that's all you get. You reduce weight and nothing else. So fasting for the sake of fasting will not deliver to you any spiritual benefit, except its purpose is well defined. When the purpose of fasting is well defined, then it releases spiritual benefits to you as a believer. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. I said, praise the name of Jesus Christ. Of course, you know, some people fast in protest to government policies. So in case you're a political activist, you can fast. Say, I'm not eating now for the next 1 year. I'm not eating until government changes its policy. So you can fast for that purpose, but that's not the kind of fasting we're talking about. Am I communicating here today? If this fast must deliver something to you, then you must define its purpose. There must be a target. There must be a goal. Jesus was led into the wilderness by the Spirit of God to fast. Why? Because of the assignment God had for him. If you go read Matthew chapter 4, verse 1 to 4, and then you read Luke chapter 4 from verse 1 down to verse number 20, you'll find everything about Jesus there. How he was led by the Spirit. He was led to fast. He was led to the wilderness and engaged in fasting by the Holy Ghost. After he was baptized by the Holy Ghost, he was led into fasting by the Holy Ghost. Now, the same Holy Ghost through his servant is instructing us right now that we should fast. Why? Because of the weight of glory that he has reserved for us this year. So that we can connect with the weight of glory. Praise the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And the Bible tells us that after Jesus returned from that fast and prayer, Luke 4 verse 14, Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit. It was a well-defined fast. He wasn't fasting to lose weight. He was fasting to connect with power. And he got it. He returned in the power of the Spirit. And his fame spread far abroad. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Come on, say, praise the name of Jesus Christ. And equally, you can fast for the fulfillment of the prophetic word of God for your life this year. Your fasting must be targeted. This year is a year of from glory to glory. From glory to glory. How can it come to pass in my life? Okay? If glory must show forth, then I must fast and pray my way into the same glory. So that the prophecy or the prophetic word can find fulfillment in my life. Can find fulfillment in my own life. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. You see the case of this man called even Jesus himself. Let me begin with Jesus Christ. Jesus the Christ. After his fast, came into the temple. And in Luke 4 verse 17, they delivered to him the book. Luke 4 17 and verse 18. He opened the book to the place where it was written concerning him. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. So he opened to Isaiah 61. He opened to Isaiah 61 and began to read from verse 1. And he read from verse 1 to verse 2. And then he stopped and said to them, this day is this scripture fulfilled in your ears. This day, This prophetic word is fulfilled in your ears. How? Through the instrumentality of prayer and fasting. He came under the anointing of the Holy Ghost. And by that anointing, he began his earthly ministry and said, hey, that prophecy now finds fulfillment. So if Jesus the Christ provoked fulfillment of prophecy through prayer and fasting, how much more should me and you press after the fulfillment of that prophetic word through prayer and fasting? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Come and say, praise the name of Jesus Christ. A servant is not above his master. A servant is not above his master. Jesus is our master. If he's your master, then you must follow his footsteps. If he fasted and prayed to encounter glory. As we continue in the course of the month, you will see instances. He went up to pray on the mountain. And he prayed until God's glory was manifested. He pressed his way into God's glory. He ministered on earth as a man anointed by the Holy Ghost. He ministered on earth not as God in his fullness. Don't misunderstand me. He is fully God and fully man. He was fully God and fully man. Yet, he set aside his divine attributes. He laid them aside and descended as a mortal man. And operated here on earth as a mortal man anointed by the Spirit. How did he get the anointing? How did he reflect God's glory? Through prayer and fasting. If Jesus the Christ needed prayer to survive or to manifest God's power and glory, then how much more me and you? Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So if you refuse to do what must be done, then you remain at the same spot. The witches will have field day on you. While others are changing level from glory to glory, you remain there from one reproach to another. But I know for someone here, the wisdom of God shall find expression in your life, and every shame and reproach in your life shall be rolled away this year in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. One of us in the house had a certain challenge, and we prayed and prayed. I prayed for my sister, and it became apparent that, hey, sister, this thing, you need to address it. Go before the Lord in prayer and fasting. Pray and fast and deal with this issue. I have fasted. I'm anointed, I know. But I have prayed, I mean rather not fast. I have prayed with all the anointing I have. This one is not responding to just my anointing. You need to play a part. Personal responsibility. And she took it up. Went before the Lord. And began. And as she continued, she took it seriously. Because challenges upon challenges dug in her path. She said, enough is enough. I said, I agree with you. Go before the Lord in prayer. Connect with his glory. She did. And in the course of the prayer, God was showing her things. She was coming to say, hey, sir, this is what I saw. I said, good and fine. Okay, this one, let's attack it. In the name of Jesus, what she saw is what we are praying about. We attacked that one. She went again to pray. And I came back and said, hey, God, show me this one. I said, go ahead. Handle it. At the end of the day, the challenge was that was confronting her just miraculously turned around like a dream of the night. Right before her eyes, everything turned. Everything turned. Everything turned. She said, it seems as if I'm still dreaming. She said, it seems as if I'm still dreaming. Why? Prayer and fasting. Some people here embarked on prayer and fasting last year, and they had outstanding testimonies to share. Somebody was healed of ulcer. Amen. Heal of ulcer during our last 21 days prayer and fasting. Somebody here also, one Rapando sister, she said during 21 days prayer and fasting, she said, I was trusting God for school fees for my son. When the schools opened, he just left without his fees. He left home with nothing. But I was still trusting God for the same. God really surprised me by providing more than what I had expected. The remaining balance, I'm going to start business with it. Blessed be the God of this commission. Sister M. Rapando. Schools are about to open. School fees shall be demanded. Somebody engaged prayer and fasting last year, or 2 years ago, I can't remember the year of this testimony here. Engaged prayer and fasting and the doors of financial blessing opened. Somebody else was sick with ulcer. And then he saw a pastor in his dream. And then the ulcer was healed. In the midst of prayer and fasting, even though he had ulcer, he decided to go on a fast. We had one brother, a single, The same way, and one other brother, Masubai, all of them. No, Sister Masubai, P, and this brother Esengo, all of them engaged in, they had ulcer, yet they engaged in fasting and prayer. And then the ulcer died. Someone here too, whatever plague has followed you, whatever crossover with you to 2016 as a plague, as you engage in this 21 days prayer and fasting, I decree that it dies and disappears from your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Through prayer and fasting, you enforce the fulfillment of the prophetic word in your life, just like Jesus did. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Come on, say, praise the name of Jesus Christ. What else? Jehoshaphat also targeted for help. Jehoshaphat fasted and prayed for help. 2 Chronicles 20, verse 3 to 24. 2 Chronicles 20, verse 3 to verse 24, to verse number 24. Jehoshaphat, when they said they were coming to fight him, he embarked on fasting. He said, Lord, we don't know what to do. We have no strength against these armies. Come and help us. And they fasted and they prayed and God stepped in. I see God stepping in for someone here this year. Every of the adversaries fighting your destiny shall be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Prayer and fasting. Number two, if you must profit from it, this is the way you should approach it. This is the way to approach it. Number two, prepare to engage your heart in seeking the Lord. Don't just pray and fast with an empty heart. Prepare to seek the Lord. If you must have an encounter with him, then you must engage your whole heart in seeking him. If you must encounter God, you must engage your whole heart in seeking him. Prepare your heart to seek the Lord with everything you have on the inside. If you must encounter him, you must seek him with your whole heart. You must engage your heart in seeking him. That is his own terms. You must come to God on his own terms, not on your own terms. God has his own rules and regulations. And the rule and the regulation and commandment is, if you want to find me, I want to see my glory, then let your whole heart be in the prayer and fasting. Don't allow distractions. Don't be in church and then your mind is in Japan or in China. Praise God. Come on, say praise God. Be all out. Be focused. Come on. Prepare your heart to seek him. Chase him and him alone. Chase him and him alone. Chase him and him alone. He said in Jeremiah 29 and verse number 13. Jeremiah 29:13, he said, and you shall seek me and find me when you shall search for me with all of your heart. You will seek me and you will find me when you will search for me with all of your heart. With all of your heart. With all of your heart. As you seek God this prayer and fasting, I see someone here encounter God in a fresh way in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Seek him with your whole heart. I beg you in the name of Christ. The way you have been doing it before has not yielded any result. Now do it the way he has commanded. Do it the way he has instructed. Do it the way he has instructed. And you shall seek me and find me. When? The day you start to search for me with everything on your inside, you will find me. Sometimes you know the way people, you know where what is in the heart of people by the way they behave and by the way they act. Am I communicating here today? Because sometimes we come for prayer meetings in church, see the way some people behave, and you know this man's heart is not here. This woman's heart is not here. Okay, let us pray. We are praying right now for the manifestation of his glory in 2015. And you see some people, every usher that is moving, they are watching. I'm just praying because we should pray, not because my heart is there. I'm not sure, let's just finish this preaching on time. Pastor Casey is already 11:20. Finish on time. Let's go.
And if nothing happens to him, he said, you see, I did everything. They said, everything you said, God, I did. You didn't do it. You did it, but not with your whole heart. But watch it. People normally share testimonies. When you see them pray, I'm not saying that shouting is equivalent to all your, but the point is, you see them concentrated. Everything is in that prayer. Grace to be fully concentrated in this prayer and fasting this year. Receive it right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. A man who has prepared his heart to see God is not seeking telephone at the same time. Put it on vibrate. And then he opens one eye. He sends short SMS. I'm praying, please. That shall not be you this year in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I said, that shall not be you this year in the name of Jesus Christ. Some people's own is worse. The moment it rings, I say, shakra, shakra, shakra. God, I'm coming. Shakra, shakra. Hello? Hello? Please, I'm praying. I'm in a 21-day prayer and fasting. I'll call you after. Okay, the consignment, the containers, they have arrived. Mombasa Port. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you. I'll see you later. See you later. In Jesus' name. Amen. God, I've come back now. I've come back. So, on this note, as we enter into 21 days of prayer, beginning from today, as you are entering service, switch off your phone. Switch off what? Help me tell your neighbor, as we enter into prayer and fasting, even beginning from today, when you are entering the church, switch off your phone. If you say, well, you see, Pastor Casey, I'm a very busy businessman and I don't want to miss some very important calls, then keep the phone in your car. Keep it where? If you cannot afford to switch it off in church, keep it in your car and lock it up. But if we catch you with phone inside the church again, I think the police station is around behind me here, right? Nobody will end there in the name of Jesus Christ. But hey, with your whole heart engaged, you will connect with God in a grand style. I see someone here reflecting the practical manifestation of God's glory in his or her life in the name of Jesus Christ. Help me tell the neighbor beside you. Help me tell him or her beside you. Nothing good comes easy. See, that is what the people in the world, they tell, that's their slogan. Nothing good comes easy. They know out there that if you want anything good to happen to you, you must pay a price for it. You want his glory? Pay the price for his glory. Moses said, show me your glory. And you know what he did to see the glory of God? With his whole heart. Go and read Exodus 33, beginning from verse number 9. Moses went and pitched a tent outside of the camp. The tent of the congregation, he pitched the tent, the temple, the meeting place with God, outside of the camp. So that anybody who wants to see God will leave the camp and make the journey to the tabernacle in order for him to seek the Lord. And Moses will leave the tent, or camp rather, he will leave the camp and walk towards the tabernacle, and everybody was watching him. And when he entered the tabernacle, the glory of God descended and they all fell down to worship. But what they didn't know was that everybody had the same chance to encounter the glory of God the same way. But nobody took the step. They are watching one man doing it. This year, you shall not watch as others are changing level in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I said, you shall not watch as others are changing level this year in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Do it with your whole heart. That's why God told Moses anytime, say, Moses, come up. Come up to the temple. Come up to the mountain. Come up to the mountain. Come on to the mountain. Why mountain? So that no distraction. No distraction, no telephone, no nothing. Come up to the mountain, just me and you. So that I can have all your attention. God requires your whole attention if you must have the whole of his glory manifest in your life. Praise God. So prepare your heart to seek him. Then number three, refuse to be offended in God. Refuse, if you must benefit from it, refuse to be offended in God and in men. Refuse for anyone to refuse to be offended in God and in people. Refuse offenses. Refuse it. Offenses will come. Challenges will come. Individuals may want to offend you, but refuse to be offended by anyone. And if anyone has offended you before, release the person from your heart now before you enter into prayer and fasting, or else your prayer will not ascend beyond the ceiling. Am I communicating right now? God is not your enemy. God is your friend. So if what you expected in 2015, you didn't see it, it's no reason for you to say, you see, yeah, I don't know. I'm not, this fasting and prayer, Pastor Casey, I tell you the truth, no matter how much you preach it, I will not fast. Last year, I did 40 days. You told us to do 21 days, I did 40. 40 days fasting and prayer. I didn't see anything. Nothing changed. In fact, things grew worse. And this one again, 21 days. No, no way. Why? God didn't do, he didn't do what I was expecting. And when God says move, say I won't move. Why? I'm not happy. Why? You disappointed me. You failed me. God can never fail. Check it critically. It's not God's fault. It's your fault. Check yourself critically. If the fault is yours, not him. Because when you were fasting and praying last year, you had somebody in your heart. And he said, if you regard anybody in your heart or iniquity in your heart, say the Lord will not hear you. So it wasn't God's fault. It was your fault. Help me tell you beside you, God is your friend. God is not against you. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. From today, I decree that whatever wants to stand between you and God, I decree that it be destroyed right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So offenses, you must let go of it. Let go. Let go. Let go. Let go. Let go. And then God will release his blessings upon you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Praise God. Paul said in Acts 24:16, he said, and herein do I exercise myself to have always a conscience void of offense towards God and toward men. Acts 24:16. To have a conscience void of offense towards God and toward men. Number four, if I must profit from the fasting and prayer ahead of us, we must come before God confessing and forsaking our sins. You must come confessing and forsaking your sins. Why? Because the Bible says in the book of Psalm 66 verse 18, that if I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. Psalm 66 verse 18, if I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. Sin will cut off the flow of his glory in your life. You can pray for 50 days or 100 days. If you allow sin to remain in your life, if you refuse to confess it and you are rather justifying it, you will never see the glory of God manifest in your life. Your fasting will just be in vain. But in order for your fasting not to be in vain, confess your sins. He's faithful and just to forgive you, whatever it is. 1 John chapter 1, verse 9 and 10. 1 John chapter 1, verse 9 and 10. If we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us. Amen. And to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. He's faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. But if we sin and we claim that we have no sin, then we deceive ourselves. And the truth is not in us. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So stop justifying sin in your life. Stop giving reasons why you want to continue in that sin. Your fasting and prayer will yield no benefit to you at all if you allow iniquity to still remain in your life. Praise God. Come on, sir. Praise God. Well, a word is enough for a wise man. So what are some of the blessedness of fasting? What are some of the benefits of fasting? We have just looked at the things you must do in order for the fasting to be profitable to you. Amen. You must let go of sin. Okay, now what are the benefits of this fasting? The blessedness of fasting and prayer. I'm going to run through very quickly. Time is already up. What are the benefits? Number one, it facilitates deliverance from all evils. It facilitates your deliverance from all evils and unwanted habits. All unwanted habits, addictions, and sins of all kinds. Fasting and prayer facilitates your deliverance from all evils. Evil character crisis, evil habits, sins in your life. So fasting and prayer is one way you can deal with the issue of sin in your life. Glory to God. Because Isaiah 58 tells us that one of the purpose of fasting and one of the power behind fasting in Isaiah 58 verse 6, God said, is not this the fast that I have chosen? To loose the bands of wickedness, to undo the heavy burdens, and to let the oppressed go free, and that you break every yoke. So every yoke is destroyed. Every yoke is destroyed when you engage in prayer and fasting with all of your heart. The yoke of sin, yoke of immorality, yoke of smoking. Some people, I think last year or 2 years ago, were testimonies of 21 days of prayer and fasting, and someone who was addicted to alcohol and to cigarette was just set free. Set free. Praise God. Set free by the power of God. Glory to God. There is no addiction that followed you into the fasting that shall follow you out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Engage with all of your heart. Engage with all of your heart. And God's power shall set you free. You know one thing? The moment you fast and pray, you are telling God that, God, I value you more than my physical food. I value you more than my physical enjoyment. I value you. I value you more. And the moment you value him more, he will show forth his worth and his value in your life also. Praise God. Come on, say praise God. By his presence invading you. His presence will invade you and destroy whatever has held you captive. Today, as you engage in this prayer and fasting, whatever has held you captive, I see them destroyed before you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Glory to God. Come on, say glory to God. That's what some of us have done over the years. Over the years, when my physical body begins to misbehave, I put it under check through prayer and fasting. Sometimes if I feel I'm sleeping too much, I just say, you this body, you want to kill me? I will kill you now. Praise God. Come on, say praise God. Come on, say praise God. One of the things that fasting and prayer will do for you is that it will make you more gentle. Am I communicating? So people that like to talk, cha-cha-cha-cha-cha, one remedy for dealing with talkativeness. Because the Bible says, in the multitude of words, there lacketh no sin. In the multitude of words, there lacketh what? No sin. So the moment you talk too much, you commit sin with your mouth. So one way you can deal with the issue of talkativeness is fast and pray. The more you are engaged in fasting, the quieter you become. You become quiet. When they see you, they know that something's, hello, is anything okay with you? Oh, yeah, yeah, I'm okay. But you look a bit inactive. Yeah, well, I'm okay. Praise God. You're not talking like before. Yes, just I need some time off to myself, please. Praise God. Come on, sir. Praise God. As you engage in this prayer and fasting, I decree that every besetting sin, the thing that easily trips you off, according to Hebrews 12, verse 1 and 2, every sort of besetting sin, I see them destroyed out of your life forever in the name of Jesus Christ. Give God some little, give him time. Give God time. Give God your time and give him your heart and see how everything begins to turn around in your life. Remember, his glory will first be made manifest in you and then through you for others to see. This year, everyone will see the finger of God at work in your own life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And of course, what else? The blessing of prayer and fasting, it facilitates answers to prayers like we have seen already. It facilitates answers to prayer. Your prayers are speedily answered in according to Isaiah 58, verse number 9. Praise God. What else? Number 3, it secures favor from God. Esther prayed in Esther 4 and verse 16 to 17. And the answer was given in Esther 5, verse 1 to verse 14. In the book of Esther, chapter 4 and 5, we see how Esther fasted. Of course, prayer was not mentioned, but we know that they must engage also in prayers. Amen. They fasted and prayed. If I perish, I perish. And she entered into the king's chambers and she didn't perish. Rather, there was a dramatic turnaround by the display of God's favor in her life. The same pertains to me and you. As you fast and pray, his strange order of favor shall begin to manifest in your life. I see someone here encounter strange favors through this fasting and prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. Blessedness number 4, it empowers fulfillment of prophecy, like we have said earlier on. It empowers fulfillment of prophecy, like in the case of Elijah. in 1 Kings 17 and 18, you find the story of Elijah and how he prophesied and how he prayed for that prophecy to come to pass, for what God has said to come to pass in his life and the life of the children of Israel. You find a condensed summary of it in James 5, verse 17 to 18. In James 5, 17 to 18, Elijah prayed again, and he prayed, and heavens were shut. He prayed again, and heavens was open, according to the word of the Lord, which the Lord spoke to him. He prayed and fasted on Mount Carmel in 1 Kings 18, and rain came down after 3.5 years of famine. The same way concerning me and you, as you pray and fast this time around, as you pray and you fast, every word that God has said in this year of glory shall find fulfillment in your own life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now, number six is that fasting and prayer also builds your prayer life. It builds your prayer life, which empowers you to see his glory. Fasting and prayer helps to build our prayer life, which empowers us to see his glory. You'll find all of that in Exodus chapter 33, from verse number 7 to verse number 19. You'll find how Moses did what I said earlier on in Exodus 33, verse 7, put the tent outside, engaged in prayer every day, and he communed with God face to face. And he engaged in fasting in chapter 34, of the book of Exodus. He went up the mountain and fasted and communed with God for 40 days and 40 nights. By the time he came back, his face was reflecting the glory of God. Likewise for someone here, by the time you are through this fasting and prayer, your face shall reflect forth the glory of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, please understand this. You must demand for God's glory in order for you to see it manifested in your life. Moses says, show me! And God showed him. As you demand for it also, he will show you, and not only show you, you partake of the same in your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hello, friends. If you refuse to pay the price, others will be sharing testimony, you remain there. Others will share testimony with you, looking at them and moping and gazing. But you will not be watching. You will not be here in church watching a cinema. You will not watch a cinema as others sharing testimony, and while you sit down there watching, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. This year, you shall be the next testifier in the name of Jesus Christ. Glory to God. Come on, say glory to God. No matter what it takes, give it all you have, and you will see God reflected in your life like never before, in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Glory to God. I said, glory to God. God's servant said, our father in the faith, he said, Lord, show me the secret behind the book of Ezekiel. And he went on a 3-day prayer and fasting on the mountain. He was looking through the scriptures of Ezekiel. And as he was going through, according to him, when he came out from that mountain, God said to him, my son David, he said, from today, as you say it, you will see it. I've touched your tongue with the coal of fire. And from today, as you say it, you will see it. That is how, from that day, whenever he declares, it comes to pass. Why? He contacted it on the mountain of prayer and fasting. He contacted it on the mountain. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. And some of the things you see around our lives, those of us who minister to you, it comes through the same way. Some things you see manifest in our lives, we take time to pray and wait before the Lord to connect with it. So that by the time we come to preach to you, things are flowing forth and happening in your life. From today, I see the strange finger of God rewrite your story in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But please understand this. We are here today to partake also of the grace of God through the prophetic mantle. We have come to partake of the grace. Now, what is impartation? It is the platform through which transference of spiritual gifts occur. Impartation is a platform for transference of spiritual gifts. It is a spiritual medium through which we partake of the grace and unction of God upon an anointed vessel. It is a spiritual medium through which we partake of the grace of God on an anointed vessel. On an anointed vessel. That anointed vessel, in this case, happens to be the prophet in the house, God's servant, Bishop David Oyedepo, called of God in 1981 in an 18-hour vision. And from that day, the unction of God, the grace of God, has never ceased to manifest in his own life. Till now, many people around the world, including myself, we normally used to joke, but sometimes we mean it, that this man is not a human being. Hey, the way he walks, the way he talks, the way he reads, the way he studies, the way he prays, the way he chases after God, this man is not ordinary. I mean, why? The grace of God. Simply nothing but the grace of God at work in his life. I have traveled with him. Amen. I have traveled with him. You have stayed with, I've watched him. You can't just explain. He tells you good night. Good night. But that good night that he has told you at around 1 or 2 a.m. in the morning, you may go to sleep, but he's not sleeping. And the grace is practically at work in his life. I've told you the story here over and again because I can never recover from it. I lived in Ethiopia for about 6 years in the country of Ethiopia as a missionary cumulatively. So I know a little bit of that country. It's far better now than what it was before. I arrived at that country in 1985. Things in that country then were still showing the vestiges of communism. Things were tight. To even enter the airport was a case. If you don't have a passport and a valid ticket, you can't enter inside. If they cannot see your ticket, they won't allow you in, except you're a diplomat. That's them. God's servant came for a visit. And we managed to get him out from the airport. He got a temporary pass. We took him out from the airport to see where we were staying because he was transiting. And we took him back to the airport and we said to him, we cannot cross the gate to enter. That is the gate to access the airport, not actually even into the airport building. Just the perimeter fence is what I'm talking about. Because there's a security man there. Let's see. What are you going for? Who are you? What are you going for? To enter that place was a problem. We have tried it before. It didn't work. So this time around, we say, excuse me, sir. Is that so? One thing about him, if you are saying anything negative or contrary to God's word, he won't answer you. If he doesn't tell you, keep quiet, he would rather keep quiet and watch you. I've observed that. If I say anything that's not in line with what he believes and what is in the word, he won't answer you. He will respond to you. So we talked. Me and Adenka spoke. He didn't answer. We just kept quiet. So when we came down, we were following him, carefully following the back of the man. I mean, because I was watching, we were following carefully, and he just walked majestically. He was a passenger. He had his visa and whatever it is. I mean, but he walked majestically. We just walked, and we were just following him. I was watching to see what will happen next. The security man was there looking at us. Not that, looking at us as we were coming. Security man was there looking at us. We're looking at him. We came and passed. He didn't say anything. I said, God, Shakataya. The man didn't say anything. I was there. He just came and passed like that. We passed and entered into the terminal, saw him off, and came and passed. The man didn't say anything. I said, Jesus. I've never seen this before in my life. I said, this country, I know them. But there was a mysterious aura around this servant. Grace that you can't deny. Grace that you cannot deny. I've seen it practically. I walk right before my eyes. Right before my eyes. So what you are receiving today is not just make-believe. It is an impartation of grace. Look, impartation is the overflow of the anointing upon his servant. He carries an anointing that is overflowing. The one I carry is limited. The one he carries is overflowing. So if my ministry has blessed you, then you can guess that by the time you receive an impartation from God's servant, you shall experience a change of level in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Glory to God. And Paul wrought special miracles. God wrought special miracles through the hand of Paul. Acts 19 verse 11. Handkerchiefs and apron were brought from his body and placed on the sick, and diseases were healed. Demons were cast out. Acts 19 verse 11 downwards. God did it through the hands of Paul. And likewise today, we have the mantle of the prophet here. He has prayed over it and sent it across to us. And this mantle, as you connect with it by faith. As you connect with it, how? By faith. Believing the word of God you are hearing. And believing the person that is the carrier of that anointing. Just like the woman with the issue of blood. She believed. That's in Acts chapter number 5. The woman with the issue of blood believed in her heart. If I touch the hem of his garment, I shall be made whole. And she touched the hem of his garment, she was made whole. Why? Jesus turned around and said, virtue has left me. Somebody has touched me. Peter said, Master, stop deceiving yourself. Everybody is thronging after you. Why are you saying, who touched me? He said, no, somebody touched me because virtue left me. And what did she touch? His clothes only. And power went out. Today, as we connect with that prophetic mantle, the grace of God upon his servant, grace for exploits, grace for favor, grace for financial breakthrough, grace for change of level. That same grace I see released into your own life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
And the prophetic mantle is the medium whereby you multiply and duplicate the grace upon the anointed. So whatever answers to his servant shall answer to you also in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. One time, a lady said to him, please, but Papa, come and pray. My business is not moving. And on his way to the airport, he passed by that woman's place and laid hands on the items. Move, move, move. You, move, move. You good, be so. And according to the lady's testimony, that not quite an hour after he left the place, somebody came and bought everything in that shop. Everything. Hallelujah. Somebody else came to meet him the same way. Hey, Papa, my business is not moving. He said, give me your hand. And he placed his hand on him and said, in the name of Jesus. He said, now go use this, your hand, the one I touched now. Go and lay it on whatever you are selling. The man had some piled up goods that refused to sell. And the man went and laid hands on them. And as he did, not quite long, a trailer came and said, hello, these items, how many do you have? He said, this is what I have. They bought everything and then gave him a line of supply. He said, we need this product on a consistent basis, so you'll be supplying all the time. Everything he had was sold, and he got a new line of supply. Through impartation of grace. Now, we did this prophetic mantle some time ago here. One of our sisters here, she works with in a particular organization, things were not moving. And according to the sister, she took the mantle and said, Father, in the name of Jesus, these things must sell. Now, we did impartation on Sunday. By Monday, she went and used them in her office. And that same week, everything they had there, everything turned around. For someone here too, as you partake of this impartation today, I decree that there be a dramatic turnaround in your own life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But for that to happen, both to receive an impartation of grace and for you to receive the glory, the manifestation of the glory of God in your life in this year, you must be born again. Like I said from the beginning, salvation is the key to manifesting his glory. Salvation is the key. Salvation is the key. Now, you are here and you are not born again and you know it. Now, everybody right now, rest of it. Rest of it right now. Now, before we partake of this communion, we want everyone here to benefit of the same. You are here today and you know that you are not born again. You know it. You know you are not saved. If you are not saved, you are not safe. If you are not saved, you cannot manifest his glory. He doesn't show his glory on sinners. No. He doesn't manifest in the lives of sinners. No. You are here today and you want this year 2016 to answer to you according to his name. Hey. It's not time to go to the toilet. I beg you in the name of Christ. It's not time to go to the toilet. It's not time to visit the toilet. It's time for you to connect with heaven right now. You are here in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You are not born again. You know it. But today you are saying, Jesus, I surrender my life to you. I want to give my life to you right now so that I can manifest your glory. I would like to pray for such individuals here today. Or maybe you are here and once upon a time you gave your life to Jesus. But today, your life is totally in your control. You took your life away from Christ. Now you are controlling your life by yourself. What do I mean? You are living your life the way you like. You are living your life to your own pleasure, not to the pleasure of God. And you know that God is not pleased with you. Now, today, you have an opportunity from God, given to you by God, to return back to him so that your life can be made meaningful, so that his glory can be reflected in your life, so that your life can begin to please him and he begins to bless you and turn you into a testimony here on earth. You are here today and you're saying, Pastor, I want to receive the mercy of God. I want his glory to be seen in my life. I'm tired of shame. I want him to cover me like he covered Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve were covered by skin of animal. He shed the blood of animal. God slaughtered an animal, applied the blood to Adam and Eve and covered them with an animal skin. The same must apply to you today. If your shame and reproach must be covered, then the blood of Jesus must be applied to you today. Now, everybody, heads bowed, eyes closed. You are here today and you are saying, preacher, I need the mercy of God in my life. I would like to pray for such individuals right now. I'd like to pray for you. You want to give your heart to Jesus? You want to dedicate your life to Christ? Place your right hand on your chest right now. Just place your right hand on your chest and I will pray with you and a miracle will take place in your life right now. Now say this after me just where you are. Say after me, Heavenly Father, I come to you today in the name of Jesus. I believe in my own heart that Jesus died and rose again for my own sake. Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Be my Lord and be my Savior. Wash me and cleanse me with your precious blood. Write my name in the book of life. Come on, say it. Write my name in the book of life. From today, I receive grace to serve you and live for you all the days of my life. Thank you for hearing me. Thank you for restoring me. Thank you for saving me. For in Jesus' name, I have prayed. Amen. Praise God. You prayed that prayer with me? I'm excited. Put your hands together for them. Put your hands together for them. You prayed that prayer with me? Now I'd like to pray for you. I'd like to pray for you right here where God's presence is available, where God's power is available, where his glory is available. Wherever you are, you pray that prayer, pick up your Bible, pick up your bag, pick up your mobile phone, whatever you came to church with, pick it up right now, walk up here to the front, and I'll pray with you here. And his glory shall be made manifest in your life in a practical dimension in Jesus' name. You pray that prayer, come on, come up right now. God bless my sister, God bless my brother, God bless you. Keep coming, keep coming. Clap for them as they come. Clap for them as they are coming. Clap for them as they are coming. Clap for them as they are coming. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Stop looking around to your neighbor or your friends. You'll be the first one to take the step from the gallery. From the gallery out there. Hold it, choir. Hold it, choir. From the gallery. You are giving your life to Jesus, or you want the mercy of God in your life. You want his glory reflected in your life. Don't just stand there. Pick your Bible and your bag and whatever it is you came to church with. Pick it up. Pick it up and be here in front right now. God bless you as they are coming. They are coming from everywhere. Keep clapping for them. They are coming. The glory of God must find expression in your life this year. This year is your year. This year is your year. Keep coming. As I'm talking right now, some people are out there. Something is telling you, go forward. Go forward. That is the voice of God. That is the voice of glory. That's the voice of change of level. That's the voice of next levels. He wants for you to change your story dramatically. Obey that voice right now. Refuse the second voice. Another voice is telling you, don't go, don't go. That second voice is the voice of the devil. He wants to stop you from accessing the glory of God. Despise the second voice. Respond to the first one. Come right now. They're coming. Put your hands together for them. Put your hands together for them. Put your hands together for them. They're coming. They're coming. They're coming. Clap for them right now. The glory of the Lord must be seen in your life this year. You must begin this year on a high note. Satan must let go of you this year. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Put your hands together for them. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. If you are coming from the gallery, we are waiting for you right now. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Now, those of you here, Kiswahili class, if you are coming, come quickly. Clap for them as they are coming. But because of our time, keep coming. Join us up right now. Now, those of you in front, congratulations. I want you to know that beginning from today, your life will never remain the same again in the name of Jesus Christ. The glory of the Lord shall be made manifest in every department of your life from this day and for the rest of your life in Jesus' precious name. You are blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now I'll pray for you. Father, thank you for bringing these ones to yourself. No man can say Jesus is Lord except by the Spirit of God. Holy Ghost, I ask and pray in the name of Jesus. Envelope them with your presence right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, give them an insight and revelation into your word and into your person in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let your glory be unmistakably seen at work in their lives from today in the name of Jesus Christ. I decree your feet planted in the house of the Lord forever in Jesus' mighty name. You are blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. And amen and amen. Congratulations, congratulations, and congratulations. Glory to God. Now, I would like you to turn around to your right hand side. Turn to your right hand side. Turn to your right hand side. You see that welcome sign there? We'd like you to follow that individual with the welcome sign. He has just one information to pass across to you. And then you will join us as we partake of this prophetic mantle in the name of Jesus Christ. Clap for them. Clap for them in the name of Jesus. Clap, clap, clap. Give them a shout of praise.